Kristen is with us, Kristen from Wall Township. Kristen, good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, you wanted to shed some light on that, the qualifications for employment at these places.
Absolutely. I'm the director of a facility, and you really want to be very careful in what you're looking for when you're looking for a child care. One of the main things that you want to look for is an accredited center. With an accredited center, they get audited regularly to make sure they're meeting the highest standards in care. And with that, every teacher on staff needs to be credentialed, meaning that they are a certified teacher caring for your child. It also comes down to leadership. The fact that this even went on at a school, it would never happen at my school. Yeah. There must have been lack of leadership overseeing what was going on within their classrooms, on their playground. This is a center that had cameras all over it. So the fact that it even could possibly happen is just mind-blowing to me.
Well, there was nobody there in any supervisory capacity watching the cameras. That was the problem. Hey, let me ask you now, Karen. Certified by whom?
Well, they would need their BA in early education, which means they would have their certified teaching credentials, or they can get a CDA, which is their early childhood certificate of development, which they go through a certification program enabling them to be just, you know, educated on what is developmentally appropriate for children under the age of 5.
You know, is it possible that people are operating these facilities who don't know that? Because we certainly talked with a number of them yesterday.
Oh, there absolutely is. So the difference between an accredited center and a non-accredited, there's a minimum requirement in order to maintain a license to open a child care center and take care of children. And it's there's very minimal qualifications for that. Nobody needs to have an education in order to do that except the director.
Yeah.
So it really depends on the company that you're going with and the research that you're doing based on what, you know, is the highest standards.
Okay, so you say you look for an accredited institution. Who does the accrediting?
Well, mine does. KinderCare, we are a national organization.
Okay.
We have 1,400 schools across the nation.
Mm-hmm.
So if you, it's a NACE accreditation. You can find other centers also that are NACE accredited. NACE is the National Association for the Education of Young Children.
Okay, so you want to look for a facility that is a member of that, presumably, and does have some indication displayed of their accreditation.
Correct. They should have a plaque. They should have a seal. They should have literature that they're able to give you at the time of your tour when you're going around. So definitely look for that when you are researching child care centers.
That is not required by law. This is something that parents simply have to do by, you know, educating themselves about this.
Exactly.
There is no legislation, though, that requires every facility that opens in New Jersey to seek that accreditation or the certification of their teachers. So,
unfortunately, there is not. Yep.
Unfortunately, there is not. Kristen, thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Have a good day.
Yeah, you too. Appreciate your calling. Yeah, that really makes a lot of sense. I guess that is the trick. It's not enough when you take the child, you're scouting it out, see their smiling face and tender, loving care written all over their faces. And then you get the Fight Club. Just be careful out there.